Happy birthday to the world's oldest operating aquarium, celebrating 150 years. The now known as Sea Life Brighton, it was formally opened to the public on August 10, 1872. The aquarium was designed by Eugenius Birch, the same engineer of the Brighton West Pier. The attraction was also used as a cinema for lectures and exhibitions. During the Second World War, it was used by the RAF, and in the 60s became a home of the Montagu Motor Museum. From the 70s until the 1991, the dolphin and seal shows were a regular part of the attraction, till Sea Life Brighton acquired the structure and released the captive sea mammals back into the wild and invested $1.5 million to turn it into what is today, with an additional over £10 million invested in the last 20 years to secure the authenticity of the building. Neil Harris, Sea Life Brighton's general manager, has organized several activities during this year and is encouraging visitors to share their experience throughout the decades within the building. I went to the VIP anniversary party to say hello to the fish and to share this special moment with you.
As we journey through the original Victorian architecture, the oldest operating aquarium in the world, we will be able to discover over 5,000 mesmerizing creatures. From the curious to the rescue, to the rare to the enigmatic. We will get the opportunity to learn about the creatures and the great work that the sea life and the animal care team do every day, whilst understanding the history of development and restoration that Merlin had done under the attraction, for the attraction.
We've worked really hard, particularly over the last couple of years, to carry out further renovation work and improvement works. And we strive for the highest standards here at Sea Life Brighton, both for everybody that visits, for our team that work here, and for the animals that often call Sea Life Brighton home.
So we're standing in part of the original building that was designed by Eugenius Birch, and the idea came from him as well. He had been over to France, seen a new aquarium that had been opened there, and his dreams to have one done in this country, and he picked Brighton, and in 1866 he had just completed and opened our beautiful West Pier, which he designed. And this wasn't just designed as an aquarium, it was designed as a place to while away the hours and enjoy yourself. So it was double what you see here. So if you imagine as you walk down those steps, the reason it's dug out is because his original designs were so elaborate that they obscured the houses along the road. So they had to dig down to be able to get the space that was needed. And as you can see, it's very Gothic as you come in. All of this is cast iron inside here. This is cast iron. Originally, light poured in. So when you came in and you saw these tanks, and he's, as an engineer and an architect, his ideas were to have the largest tanks that had ever been built.